I'm pleased to have with us this morning Julia Steyn.
Thank you for having me.
Julia has been with General Motors for the last several years before running Maven, which she will talk about at length during this session. Maybe you can talk to us a little bit about your perspective and what specifically brought about the creation of Maven. How is that an answer to some of these trends that you're seeing?
So we've launched Maven, which is now focused on the car sharing, both directly to the consumer, as well as also running fleets and in the ride share context for Uber and Lyft and other participants of the gig economy. I've been at General Motors now for 5 years. So I came after the bankruptcy. The company was very focused in the beginning of restructuring, lowering costs, managing the footprint. And you could see that over 5 years, the idea of design, build, and sell, which is a typical manufacturing company and engineering company powerhouse, started to be challenged in the eyes of our consumer. At the end of the day, the car is a consumer product. And if you travel throughout the globe, it's very apparent that consumers stopped consuming transportation in the same way how we were offering it to them. The rise of the shared economy, the idea that owning a car in a big city is just so ludicrous because the parking is $1,000 a month and you have to stand in line for the DMV to get the registration. It's just not something people want to do. And you can either close your eyes to the fact or you can just embrace it. And when Mary Barra became CEO, we started very firmly embracing this shift culturally. The first thing that we now talk as part of strategy is we want to earn customers for life. And to earn customers for life, you need to offer different solutions for the mobility problem. On the flip side, the technology actually is moving along pretty dramatically. So what has been also changing in the traditional model and the engineering part of the house is the speed, how the technology started to iterate. If before it took 6 years to really do a car from ground up, it takes 6 year process. When you look at the technology space, it's months, it's weeks. And so these two worlds are coming together in a very interesting way now.
Talk to us a little bit about the different culture that you're growing inside GM and how does that jive? How does that work?
Well, Michael, this is a very important point. If you look at the evolution, what happens next from the kind of the manufacturing and the engineering model? Now we need to grow capabilities to providing transportation as a service. And people talk about this a lot in the automotive space right now. But fundamentally, being a service requires different capabilities because you do very different habit formation with a customer. It's not like you sell them a car every couple of years through a dealer. You want them in your service every week, every couple of days. So that was one of the big reasons why we launched a new brand. And just to give you an example of the demographics, and taking aside GM brands, the youngest automotive brands, the average age is in the mid-50s, and that's the youngest, and it goes only upward from there. So where is all this generation who are 30, 40, 20? It's gone, right? It's not part of this equation, or it's becoming a smaller part of this equation. So we wanted to launch a brand that's only focused on service with very different habit formation, so which means very different approach to marketing, very data-driven, very focused.
If we take a step back, GM clearly is investing billions of dollars and tremendous amounts of focus in retooling itself to this disruption. Talk to us about the pillars of that and how does Maven fit into that overall change?
Sure. And this again comes back to the whole concept that the world of mobility is moving towards a service. So everything that we do right now builds towards that. So again, we've invested in the engineering and artificial intelligence capabilities. That's the development of the technology that is backbone of when you look towards the move to the autonomous world. So this is, again, building the pillars of what it takes to be able to really coherently have a service from the fleets, from, again, the world is moving to the electrical vehicles, and the autonomous vehicles will have a large part of that is electrical. So that means bringing a whole new focus on the infrastructure. Yeah, and historically, in the US, that hasn't been a strong topic of the conversation, and it's very fragmented, very regional. And so, again, bringing focus and solving with now deploying Chevy Bolts that have 250-mile range, using them in the ride-sharing context through Maven and running these fleets, now we're kind of solving the chicken and egg problem, because you can have a utility that wants to talk to the operator of the charging station and the real estate. So all of this is coming together.
And so you mentioned the Chevy Bolts and kind of the fact that you, as part of the group that is being built in GM, is developing these services. It must be difficult to do that, given that the more there's the inherent conflict internally, right? The more cars you put through these services, the less cars, but presumably they're being sold directly. The more, you know, you lean into services, the less you're a product company. Do you feel that, or is the organization really kind of aligned now with a strategy where there's less resistance internally to change?
Let's face it, if you look, like let's take the United States, and you take out the coasts and look in the middle, people are going to need to use trucks and cars, and this is where there's a lot of land and a lot of different types of environments. It's going to be there for a while. Let's not kid ourselves. In the urban environments, it's a very different story, and that's where we started the conversation. We see consumers consuming transportation in a vastly different way.
Okay. And we touched on autonomous, and that's obviously what's at the forefront of what people read about every day. So there's the sharing part, the autonomous part. How related are they in your strategy? So how do you see autonomous affecting the service part of GM?
Well, it all will come together, because look, right now there's an engineering effort which needs to be done on the autonomous front. It also needs to feed into the service element. And so ultimately, again, all of the world is going to converge, but it's going to have different slices of it for a period of time, right? And consumers want choices. So you can ask me, why on earth are you doing car sharing? Well, you know what? If you go into the restaurant, I guarantee you'll use Lyft or Uber because you're going to have a drink. But if you're going to go for a weekend in the Hamptons, you want an elevated version of accessing. So there's going to be different elements of how we play. Autonomous is going to start somewhere, and it's going to grow in a different offerings as well. So we just have to be mindful that the consumers will want choices and ability to fit it into their lifestyle.
I hear a lot about the comparison between the changes in the auto industry and what happened in the communications industry and cell phone industry when Apple came in. It sounds like there's a lot of change, or more rapid change, that occurred in communications that is occurring in GM and maybe your competitors, but you believe that you'll be able to change in time and adapt, and the industries, while it's being quote-unquote disrupted, is actually going to come out as a service industry with a different business model.
Yes, I definitely do believe that. And it's interesting. It's always a question, what is your starting point? And again, Tesla admirably came into automotive industry and proven that somebody new can be a part of the industry in an important way. And that's exciting. And I think a lot of things that they did, a part of the car itself, is also innovating. Obviously, Uber and Lyft came with a very different perspective. When you have a lot of assets, you come to it with a starting point of a lot of responsibility as well. And how do you change responsibly? And how do you really take all the assets that you have and move it into a different direction?
To kind of put a projection out there, you think that the General Motors and its major competitors will become much more of a service business over the next 5 years? Is that going to become more and more a revenue stream and a business change in the industry?
It will definitely become a business change, and it will evolve. Everything has its sort of natural evolution process, but services are going to become very important, and not because we decide they're important, it's because the consumers decide they're important, and now we're going to have to adapt and do that.
All right. Julia, thank you very much for coming to Goldman Sachs.
Thank you for having me.